Welcome student. Today we are going to discuss the reason of this lesson, that is natural resources. Okay, we are going to read this lesson. Read and getting the explanation of this lesson. So we have to go through the important point. The important point that is come in the lesson. Here is the first which we bracket the line from this. This is an important line. The natural resources means the definition. Definition of natural resources. The natural things that man uses are called natural resources. So here in this lesson we can get the definition right. The definition of natural resources, that the things which we get through the nation. So natural resources, naturally that things are available to fulfill our needs. Okay, so the next explanations of this definition is the man fulfill his need using these natural resources. So what are that natural resources? The natural resources are air, water, soil, land, mineral, plant and animals are natural resources. Okay, so here we get the definition and the its examples in this paragraph. So it is important paragraph for you to learn this paragraph, write down it and by heart. Okay, so the next of this is we are going through one by one natural resources. The first natural resource is air. Okay, it the air is available in a plenty. It never decline or it never increase. Okay, so air, we cannot manufacture air, but we get it naturally. Okay, so this is the important point of this lesson. On the next page, look at these persons who are working. Okay, who are workers, but they uses the natural resources. The activity which they done in this picture shown that is based on the natural resources. Look at the first person. He is plowing the field. He is doing agriculture. He is a farmer. Okay, he is a farmer. The second one is a fisherman. He is throwing his net into the sea or water, into the water, to gather fishes. Next one is he gathered a honey, collect a honey from the tree. So the honeys are produced by the honeybees. They are available in a nature. Okay, the next one, that is the figure 8.5, the man collect water from the well. Okay, and next the woman and that man is carried a wood for the fuel purpose, daily fuel purpose. Okay, and the next, there are soils which gathered in a dumper, which is at the mining. The it is a coal mining. Okay, next picture is about a mason. his construction, the construction of house, okay, mason is a worker. He uses bricks made from the soil. And next person is gathering salt at one side, okay. And in the next picture, there is a lady who collected the rubber latex from the rubber tree. And the last picture is of a man gathered the resin through. So these are the businesses which indulge the manpower, and that businesses are depend completely on nature. Okay. Look at the next page. Here is a picture of an ass. Okay, he is used as an animal is used to carry a load. Generally, the iron person uses or the vadar who carried out the heavy material on the back of the ass. So human uses animals as for the purpose of transportation. Okay. In the next point, we have experienced the next natural resource is soil. Okay, soil. Soil, it is available in a plenty to the human beings. So human being uses this soil for their various purpose. As we earlier saw a picture of a mason who is constructing house with the help of soil made bricks. Okay, soil made bricks. Next, look at the next picture that shows the different vegetations which is available on the earth. Okay, it is started from the equatorial region, that is the 0 degree up to 15 degree north upward. Okay, north side, at the equatorial region we can see many jungles which is called as a evergreen forest. And then at the 15 degree from the equator, we have a deciduous forest, small trees. Okay, and in the tropical region, there was a major grasslands are available in the tropical region. Thorny shrubs in the 30 to 45 degree Celsius, and temperate grassland is available at the 45 degree to 60 degree. Mixed forest we experiences at 60 to 70, broadleaves forest and coniferous forest is we can experience at the above 75 degree, and at the 90 degree we have this tundra region. There we have very snowfall, ice everywhere. Okay, so in this point we can have a next point, that is the classification of plants. Okay, Here we have that points, that is the grass, herbs, shrub and trees are classified the forest, okay. Due to this classification, we can understand what actually the position of the environment is, okay. Experimented with some guys grasses to obtain a food grains. This helped him to avoid a plentiful painful wandering life. So after the invention of the agriculture, a human being started to settle at a particular place where the agriculture becomes a prominent occupation of the human being, okay. So here we have important from this to this, okay. Man has successfully experimented with some grasses to obtain a food grains and help him to avoid a painful wandering arc of gathering food, okay. So here this is a very important point in this lesson, okay. The next important line is the next paragraph, that is the we obtain products like wood, rubber, resin, fruits, medicinal plant, etc. from forest. So here we have very much use of a forest. The tribal area, the tribal person's life is totally dependent on the on this forest, okay. So there are many types of forest. First, the temperature zone, we can classify the forest with the help of temperature zone. Like natural vegetation, evergreen, equatorial deciduous forest, tropical grassland, etc. Okay, mixed forest, broadleaves forest, coniferous forest, tundra forest, etc. The animals who many animals are situated having a habitat in this type of forest, okay. Thus in the forest that animals develop their food chain while plant eaters and coniferous animals also develop in this forest, okay. So we can underline this important point of the classification of this forest, okay. That is tropical evergreen forest, deciduous, tropical island, all these, okay. Here on the next page there is an important point, that is this means that the land is also a natural resource. So land also considered as a natural resource. The living things that are born on a land grows, live and die on land itself is an invaluable resource. So for the agriculture purpose, land is a very essential part of the agriculture. So human being having a natural use of this natural resources. Okay, next, the depending on the documents like physiography, soil, climate, material, and the availability of water in the different region of the world, the land and the forest for various purposes, the proportion of land on the earth is 70, proportion of the land on the earth is 29.20%, 29.20%, okay, so very much less amount is available with the human being, so we have to use poverty in proper way. Okay, so students, we will stop here, and after that we will continue in the next lecture.